I love me a good Linus Torvalds rant as much as the next person, and I especially love it when Linus is just saying it as it is. And you may not agree with every position he takes, but at least with Linus, you know exactly what you're getting into, right? You're not seeing some fake personality, you're seeing Linus Torvalds, or Linus Torvalds, or however you want to say his name. He actually doesn't care. I've done a video on this in the past. People keep bugging me about, oh, it's not Linus, it's actually Linus. Literally does not care. He's talked about it multiple times. Right now, we're in the development cycle for the 6.15 kernel, and this patch set was made by Dave Ailey. DRM for 6.15-RC1. As always, when I talk about DRM in the context of the Linux kernel, this is Direct Rendering Manager, not Digital Rights Management. This is a patch set for the graphics stack. This is the main DRM pull request for 6.15. Bit late, but my wife was away getting a PhD, and kids took over my writing summaries time, and FDA was offline last week, which slowed me down a small bit. Oh yeah, that also happened last week. I didn't do a video on this, but the FDO, I did do a video on beforehand. Free Desktop was having their infrastructure moved over from one system to a new one, and this coincided with that downtime. Dave Ailey does a lot of great work in the kernel. He's probably shown up in various videos in the past, but never really been the main focus, and this time is no exception. The main focus isn't really the patch set from Dave Ailey, it's just the way the DRM subsystem works. Unlike a lot of the rants we see, where Linus goes off on the quality of the PR, not following procedures, shipping broken code, things like that. In this case, the issue is actually with the test files. And here is Linus's response. Grrr. By itself, great response initially. I have seen a lot of emails from Linus. I don't think I've ever seen one that starts off with grrr. I don't know why he decided to talk like a teenage girl. But more important than that, I did the pull, resolved the trivial conflicts, but I noticed that this ended up containing the disgusting HDR test crap that A, slows down the build because it's done for a regular all mod config build rather than be some simple thing that you guys can run as needed, and B, also leaves random HDR test turds around in the include directories. Just this line right here is what made me want to make the video. Going and calling the temporary test files that the test thing leaves around turds, of all the words you could use, that by itself, beautiful, incredible, poetry. There is just something about the way that Linus rants and the way that Linus communicates that you just don't get in many other projects that I really feel like does make Linus a good leader. I do think he does let things go on a bit too long without stepping in sometimes, but when he actually does step in, there is a lot of fake people in the FOSS world. These people where, in public, they will put on this, like, nice persona. They pretend to be a nice person, but behind closed doors, or the second you step slightly outside of the imaginary boundaries that you had no idea existed, they immediately roach out. They immediately show their true colors, and you realize, oh, I'm not dealing with a nice person, I'm dealing with a snake. People like this are absolutely insufferable because I have no idea how to handle them. I can deal with actual nice people, and I can deal with assholes because I know what I'm dealing with. If I'm dealing with an asshole, hey, like, yeah, they're gonna be mean to you. Yeah, they're gonna say something that might offend you. But you know that it's gonna happen. There's no situation where things are going well and then you do something slightly wrong and then suddenly they explode. You know how to make them explode and you know how to not make them explode. Now, I think it's fair to say that young Linus, look, maybe he went a bit too far, and he certainly has matured quite a bit out of some of those early email list conversations. But even back then, like, you knew what you were dealing with when you were dealing with Linus. There was no surprise there. He might be mean to you, but you know why he's being mean to you. Anyway, side tangent over, back to the email. People already complained separately about this. It should never have made it to me in this broken form. Why the heck is this testing being done as a part of the regular build? And damn it, we don't add random turd files for dependencies that then make the source tree nasty. The thing that made me notice it was still there was that Git status complains about the stupid turds not being ignored, but more importantly, those turds also break file name completion. So no, adding it to Git ignore doesn't actually fix the problem. It would have just made me not notice as quickly. So even if it's being Git ignored, it's still gonna be used by other commands you might run and still showing up as something that is there and being annoying. This thing needs to die. If you want to do the HDR testing, do it as part of your own checks. Don't make everybody else see the disgusting thing and have those turds in their tree. I'll just disable it by marking as broken for now. You guys can figure out what you want to do, but no, forcing others to see those things is not the answer. I would suggest you not make this part of the kconfig setup and normal build at all, but be something where you can run it as part of your tests, i.e. do it as a make DRM HDR test kind of thing, not as part of regular builds. Now, just to be clear on what Linus is ranting about here, basically this HDR test thing is part of the regular build process for this part of the kernel. Not as a separate test thing you can run if you feel like running the tests, but run as part of the regular build. And when this test runs, it creates a bunch of files that are not cleaned up after everything is done, the aforementioned turds, causing them to litter the directory. Now, initially, that was the end of the discussion and where I was going to end the video. But since then, there has been some follow-up replies. Here is one from Johnny Nicola. Fair, I hear you about disabling it, but they would like it to be part of the regular build process, just hidden behind a kconfig. We're doing build time checks, and kbuild gives us all the machinery to make it happen. Without the dependency tracking, you'd have to check everything every time, and that's just going to mean people won't run it. Truly make this opt-in, only for developers who actually want it. Below's a patch to make it happen. We'll probably want to add more checks like this in the future. We want to catch a whole bunch of build issues up front. And here is that patch in question if you're curious to see what is actually being done here. And here's another reply from Simona Vetta, mea culpa also from the DRM maintainer side. As Jenny explains below, we really want to make this and similar things happen in DRM, and we thought this much more limited version would address your concerns. Evidently not. We also got a heads up from the kbuild maintainer that you really don't like this, and I guess that wasn't clear enough in the PR cover letter. Plus, at that point, it was all already in DRM Next, and we figured it's not worth the trouble of pulling it out and doing a separate topic branch PR so you can check it out separately. Hindsight and all that, cheers, Simmer. And Linus also responded, I live in autocomplete. I basically never type out file names, and I replace keyboards every once in a while because my tab key is worn down. Not really, but you get the idea. And if this feature is useful, while I disagree about the whole header files have to be self-sufficient as a general rule, I can see it being useful for UAPI headers, then damn it, the file naming needs to die. It needs to be taken out behind the shed and shot in the head because it messes with tab completion. Man, I don't even know what to say about Linus. Like, you know exactly what you're gonna get from him. Having this has been checked turds that live in the same namespace as real files is wrong. In the kernel, we often hide them explicitly, i.e. using the dot prefix to make them hide, but also make them not mess with autocomplete. That's an option, but some people hate the hiding, and if that's an issue, just put it all in a different subdirectory entirely. In a different directory, you never have to think about it. Yes, an extra folder there, and yes, that might tab complete, blah, 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 but like, it's only one thing, not a bunch of other files. Yes, I realize that you guys may live in a whole different subdirectory entirely. World of doing the whole build process in a separate build directory, you might say, why you work in the same tree as the generated files in the first place if autocomplete is so important to you? And to that I say, because I equally often look at the generated files when they make sense to look at, not when they are auto-generated makefile checking crap. So please, this feature needs to be done completely differently. This video is not important whatsoever. You probably learnt nothing of value here. But you got to see another Linus Torvalds rant, and frankly, that's all that matters. Yeah. So if you sat through this to the end, thank you. I don't know why you did that, but you're a cool person. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video, and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, Patreon, subscribe, Silly Parapay, link in the description down below. Also, let me know your thoughts in the comment section as well. That'll be good for the algorithm. Yeah, that's gonna be it for me, so. Yeah. What is this?